What he did well last night was when Iverson got in foul trouble, he really stepped up and he controlled himself and took good shots.
Allen, straight up, got a good look. Somebody got a hand in his face there and picked it up underneath.
I think maybe it was going to Hayward.
Or King. Iverson on the other end.
They're going to charge. They're going to charge.
That's foul trouble time now for Allen. He's shaking his head. He can't believe it.
And he's staring and he can't believe it. What a job he has done when he made the transition, came out of the high school ranks of Washington, D.C.
That changes the next 4 minutes and 3 seconds and maybe changes the first 5 minutes of the second half.
Yeah, because he'll probably have to play with Allen for the first five.
Ray Allen's probably happy he's not out there.
Yeah, Ray's got to really go explode to the basket a little more. He can be an excellent transition player. I have seen him utilize his quickness. He's one of the great first halves I've ever witnessed in the game going over.
Look out, it's a two-on-one here. King and Allen. Allen with a left hand. King tried to follow, but Jahadi White throws it off. Now Victor Page will have to run the show as he did last night. Loose ball. Comes out to Kyobu. Iverson got in foul trouble last night. That's what led to Victor Page's explosion for 34 points because Allen found himself in the same situation last night as he's in right now.
And we wrote down the score, and when that happened, they really were in trouble, but they gained. It was unbelievable how they gained because of the performance of Page.
Nichols. I think Jeffrey got a piece of that. And the ball loose comes out to Ray Allen. Jeffrey. Back out to Allen. He's all alone. Then it goes up and over the backboard.
He had a good look. That was a good shot right there.
3 minutes, 13 seconds remaining first half. UConn clinging to a two-point lead.
He's such a tough guy where he feels like he's one of the best all the time whenever he's playing basketball. So when he's out there, nobody's better than him in his mind, and nobody can stop him in his mind. You know, he's the best, and he's going to go and compete with anybody who steps out there to guard him. You know, he's very low to the ground. He's not a tall guy. He's not big. He's not muscular at all. And that allows him to be so quick that, you know, you can't believe it. And he just moves quickly, laterally, and, you know, up and down the court. And it's like, you know, when you got the ball down, he can get around you so quick and take it from you. Or, you know, and he definitely can jump up there with seven-footers and dunk on him. So that's what makes him a really tough player.
Jim Calhoun, what a job he's done at Northeastern, at Connecticut, his 10th year.
Co-coach of the year in the Big East this year.
Yeah, I'm taking it away from certainly Jim O'Brien, a solid job, and I find that tough to comprehend when you're 17-1 and you lose.
Jahadi White almost brought everything down.
Jahadi White, he's just getting more and more minutes because he's being so productive.
It's a good thing they had to chase that basketball down and call it official moment there by Jim Burr because the whole backboard support is still shaking down.
What good stance, good movement defensively. Just an excellent job right here by Jamomo. Look at his defensive stance. I mean, that is a perfect stance. He's got good balance. Look at his eyes. Look at the concentration. Look at my eyes. Hey, Shuffle, you can't beat me. You can't make the turn. I'll stay between you and the basket.
Rudy Johnson's wide open. Knight trying to pick up a backside rebound. Lost it out of bounds.
Take a look at the balance right now, young kids. Look at the balance he has defensively. Look at the concentration. Look at the head. Look at it. He's taking him. He's leading him where he wants to take him. You can either fan or you can fight.
Here's a double team on Victor Page, and he calls timeout. He couldn't find anybody open. And John Thompson, I don't think, was too excited about the timeout being taken there.
John Thompson had that great run, and he mid-80s when he won the national title in 84 and 85. He lost that heartbreaker, that unbelievable performance by Villanova and Pinckney and company and Rolly Massimino. 82, he went right to the buzzer, and it was a young guy, a diaper dandy, a freshman by the name of Michael the Magnificent, who hit a big, big shot. But Georgetown went 3 out of 4 years to the final game of the NCAA championship.
Last time a team's won the Big East championship, there are the years. Big East in the ACC, thinking about 6 teams, may or may not happen. But all of that will come to a head tomorrow at 6:27 with Ms. Botchell, Mr. Phelps, and Mr. Fowler and company. 2 minutes change left in a 40-40 tie. Page missed the jumper. Nichols off balance trying to get to that ball, and now to